Hello everyone, myself Sushma C. I am working as a guest lecturer in Department of Botany, ADB First Grade College, Harappanahalli. I have completed 80% of my syllabus and another 20% of the syllabus has yet to be complete, will going to be completing through these videos. In this video, I am going to explain about Mendelian genetics, particularly about monohybrid cross. Dear students, in our regular classes, we came across some of the terms which are used in genetics, like homozygosity or homozygous condition, heterozygosity or heterozygous condition, phenotype, genotype, alleles, etc. Before going to know about monohybrid cross in detail, let us know what is monohybrid cross or what is the actual meaning of monohybrid cross. The cross between the two parents differing in a single pair of contrasting characters is known as monohybrid cross. Every cross is going to be done between the two parents and those two parents must be differ in some of the characteristic features. That is the basic rule of a cross. Here in this cross, the parents which are involved are having all the similar characters excepting one character, and such a cross is known as monohybrid cross. The resultant of this cross is called monohybrid. For this, Mendel selected pea plants which are differ in only one character, that is height of the plant, height of the pea plant or length of the pea plant. He crossed one tall plant with the dwarf plant. Let us check or let us know what was the result got by the Mendel. Tall plant is crossed with dwarf. This is the phenotype. Genotype for tall is capital T, capital T, and for genotype for dwarf plant is small t, small t. Observe the phenotype and genotype, because all the similar characters along with the height of the pea plant, other characters are also there, but here we are indicating only the peculiar character or contrasting character. And we know that each character in an organism is going to be influenced by pair of factors or genes called alleles. So Mendel used English alphabets to indicate the factors. If one English alphabet is written, it indicates one gene. If two is written, pair of genes. Here, tallness is indicated by pair of genes or factors. That's why here Mendel used two capital T. Here for dwarf, he used two small t. Capital T indicates, and small t is also indicating both are in homozygous condition, which means they are pure in nature. From the homozygous tall, one type of a gametes are going to be formed. That is, each gamete is going to carry the same character T and T. From dwarf also, small t, small t. On crossing, capital T, small t, capital T, small t, capital T, small t, capital T, small t. So observe, all the result is similar. So that is why we have taken only one for clear understanding. In F1 hybrid, all are tall. All the plants are having tallness, showing their tallness, having the genotype heterozygous tall. One is capital T and another one is small t. This result gives Mendel the idea of law of dominance. According to Mendel, when two factors are brought together in F1 hybrid, the factor which express its character is called dominant factor, and the factor which do not express or suppressed is called recessive. This is known as law of dominance. So according to Mendel, on this result, according to Mendel, in F1 hybrid, all the plants are tall. So tall plant, even though there is a presence of dwarf factor, tall is exhibited, which means tall is dominant over dwarf. So tall is dominant factor, whereas dwarf factor is recessive. This law is known as law of dominance, given by Mendel on observing the result of monohybrid cross, particularly by observing the F1 hybrids. Mendel continued his experiment to know the result of F2 generation by selfing the F1 hybrids. When Mendel allowed the F1 progeny for self-fertilization, both the parents are having same genotype, that is capital T small t and capital T small t. There are two possible types of gametes in both the cases. Among four possible types of crossing, three plants are resulted with tallness and one plant is going to be resulted with dwarfness. So the result will be, the phenotypic ratio is 3:1 and the genotypic ratio is 1:2:1. Three are tall and one is dwarf. This is the phenotype. What is the genotype or the character influenced? The pair of alleles are, one is homozygous tall, carrying both the similar genes, and the two are heterozygous tall, having two different factors, resulted in a dominant character. One is homozygous dwarf. One thing we have to remember, that every recessive character is going to be exhibited in an organism when it is in homozygous condition. On the basis of this result, Mendel gave another law which states, when a pair of factors are brought together in F1 hybrid, they remain together without mixing or blending, and they get segregate or separate at the time of gamete formation. Thus, a gamete receives only one factor among the two. Hence, this law is also known as law of purity of gametes. When a pair of factors are brought together in F1 hybrid, pair of factors are capital T, small t, small t. When they are brought together in F1, F1 is capital T, small t, both the genes or factors are present in one individual, they appear like mixing or blending each other. They were not going to be blended or mixed. They get separated during gametes formation. These two factors are going to be get separated, and each one factor is going to be entered into two different gametes. If they are involved in any mixing, they will not going to be get separated in any circumstances. They get separated during gametes formation indicates that both are remains pure. Hence, this law is also known as law of purity of gametes. Dear friends, remember, the phenotypic ratio of monohybrid cross is 3:1 and genotypic ratio of monohybrid crosses 1:2:1. Monohybrid cross gives two laws or suggest two laws. One is law of dominance and another one is law of purity of gametes, which was explained by Mendel. Thank you.